Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys nodes based on a subscriber request. I'll do my best to try to make this quick so it's not as long as the Lord of the Rings or a Coen Brothers movie, but there's quite a bit to cover. First off, we'll just go over what a node is. You can access your nodes with this little drop-down menu here in the upper right, and this area is called the node graph, and this is where all your nodes live. The node is basically a control point for your image. So you could see this line goes through and connects. That's your timeline out, goes into a node, and comes back out. Now we have several different nodes. First off, let's just look at the node functionality and drop-down menu. So we have a lot of functions here like reset. You can label a node and enter some text here. You can lock a node, give it a color. You can add a node from here. There are shortcuts. You can have a shared node. You can delete shared nodes. Delete the node in general, make it HDR. Node caching is if you have an effect like a noise reduction or film grain, it'll cache that effect into the node. You can add a LUT, change color spaces, gamma tag, work on your individual channels, add a mat, and change your composite node. Now, adding nodes, you can use your shortcuts or you can right click and hit add node. So let's go over the types of nodes that are in here. We got serial, before and after, a parallel, a layer, and an outside. So serial nodes work by feeding from one to the other. So any changes you make on a node, it's going to take that change and feed it into the next one in a serial fashion. Sometimes you want to do that. Sometimes you need to add a node prior to that. So you can hit Shift S, and that's going to add a serial node before. Once again, all these shortcuts are right under here. And then you also have a color menu up here with the node section, and there's quite a few different ones here if you want serial nodes with power windows and a few other things. Now you can enable and disable a node by selecting it, hitting Command D.
Learn it, know it, live it.
So if we made a change here and we wanted to look and see a preview of whether we liked it or not, with that node selected, we can hit Command D. You can actually grab more nodes than one, and they'll turn dark when they're deactivated. So that's your serial before and after. Another thing to note with nodes is if you hover over them, they will tell you what the node is doing. So here it says custom curves. There's a little custom curve icon right here. And you can see we've made a change here. Down on the color controls, you can see a little red dot showing this is active. So if we reset it, that dot goes away and the icon goes away. Now let's go through some node types here. So we went through serial before and after. There's a parallel, and this will add a parallel mixer. Now, unlike the serial nodes where each one feeds into the other, you can see we have two clean feeds coming out of our timeline and mixing into this parallel mixer here. Now, there are some functions you can change from the parallel mixer here, including morph it into a layer mixer, change some inputs. What this does is take whatever changes are on each node and then mixes them together. So you have independent control. There's another kind of node, and we'll look at that in a minute if you want to blend it a certain way. Basically, you could stack these up. They all join to here. And then from here on out, you could add more serial nodes downstream. So that's a parallel. Now we're going to add the layer node. Now this looks a little bit different, although at first glance, they sort of look the same, but the icon's different. And if we click on the layer mixer, you could see we have some different functionality. So you can still add nodes, inputs, you can morph it to a parallel, but you can change the composite mode. And this works with some of your keying features like magic mask and alpha input, things like that, and changes how they blend together. So that's pretty helpful. It's not just like two single inputs. It'll let you layer them in a certain way. Next up, we have an outside node. So I'll go to another shot to show you that. Here's a good use for an outside node. Let's say on our first node here, we added a power window. We did a circular. I'm going to invert it. And what that means is if we hit highlight here, which is Shift H, you could see anything inside this window is getting manipulated and everything with the gray highlight is not being manipulated. So you could drag this out and kind of do like your typical vignetting a little bit. And then I'm going to invert it here with this little button. And now this is like the safe zone and anything outside is being affected. So let's lower the gamma here and I'll turn the highlight off and I'll turn this overlay off with Shift tilde. And then we can go Command D and this is sort of what it's doing right now. Now, if we right click, hit add node and say add an outside, It's going to add a alpha output into the secondary node. And if we highlight the second node, you can see it's doing the inverse. So node one is isolating the outside of the power window, and node two is now showing you what's inside. So if we wanted to like raise the gain or give it some lift, whatever you might want to do, now you could see those changes just inside that inside outside nodes. All right, a few things to know about working in the node area. You can right click in this gray space and reset nodes, reset node stack, which we'll get into later. You can also add a node from this menu instead of right clicking on the node. You can add a source, which will give you another green output, and you can add an alpha output, which gives you a little blue dot right here if you wanted to isolate something for compositing. So you have some more functions outside here, including zoom in or zoom out, toggle display mode if you want to zoom into your node graph and get rid of your preview. And then you have original size. You also have a slider here to zoom in and out if you need to. There's the selection arrow and a hand tool up at the top here, which will help you move your node graph around. Sometimes if you move your preview window, these will go off screen, and that's a good way to kind of get things back on. And conversely, you can hit option and scroll, and that zooms in and out your view as well. You can hit original size. So there's some of the functionality there. One other thing of note is the flow of your signal within your nodes. So you can see here on the upper right, it says clip L1. I actually have node stack on. So our second clip layer is director. For right now, I wanted to point out timeline. That timeline node is a timeline specific node that'll make an adjustment on all layers of your timeline. So if we look right here and we choose timeline, right now I have a single layer, but if we had elements stacked up on the other video tracks, it's gonna affect all of those layers, whether it's an adjustment clip, some B-roll, all that'll be affected by a timeline node. So let's add a serial in the timeline node. We could see it's blue. So I'll click that and we'll go to the blur, and I'm just gonna blur it. So now if I click on any other clip here, you can see they're all blurred even though there's no color correction or anything on these clips. So that's what a timeline node is. Now you have a few more nodes to choose from. There's some shared nodes and group nodes. So let's take these shots here and I'm gonna shift click to highlight them all. I'm gonna right click and we have this group section right here. We could add into a current group, a new group, or remove, and then you can manage your groups here. So let's make a new group. So I'll call it enter, and you can see you get these little green chain links. So now let's go back to our clip view. If I grab this node and we'll start making some changes, maybe make some contrast changes. Right now we're on the clip level, so we're still making individual clip changes. But if we come over here, we're gonna reset this, use this dropdown. We have group pre, which does changes before the node we are just on, before the director node, and before the group post or timeline. So let's go pre. You can see the node changes color. And now if I change this, you can see the preview changes on all the group clips down here. So that's how the signal flows, is how these dots are laid out, or this dropdown shows you. So keep that in mind. It's kind of like the serial nodes as they feed one into the other. So I'm gonna go ahead and delete this node. Same thing if we went over to the group post. We have another node there, and you can make it as extensive of a node tree as you want in here, so it doesn't really matter. So that's another node type. I'm gonna go ahead and delete this group. You can do that from the groups menu here. You can see it's checked. And if I say delete, it'll ask me if we're sure. And now that group batch goes away. Now there's another one that is similar. And right here, I already have it on this node. It's called a shared node. So if we right click or we say add a node, if you have a shared node, it'll be right here. And this will give you a little label that says shared and show you some arrows, and it locks it for you. So let's say you're dialing in a look here, and we like this node. You can still disable and enable it, but here's the change. If I go to the secondary clip, this node has nothing going on. So if I right click, you could say add node, and now we have a new shared node option. I'm gonna click that. It's gonna make a new node. It's also locked, but it shares the properties of this first clip here. So that's yet another node. If you wanted to make a change, you could right click and unlock that node. It's now active. So let's make a change. Bring up the blacks a little bit. Now, if we go to the first clip, you can see it looks pretty much the same because that shared node is sharing that those changes. So it's sort of like a group clip, but it's just called a shared node. Now, one other thing you can do within your nodes here, if you have an extensive node tree, I'm going to go over to my gallery and my power grades, and I'm going to drop a bigger node tree on here. So that's going to override any of the nodes. And this is now on the director level. So we still have layer one with that single node. Anything we do here is going to feed out into this director node. While I'm at it, let me show you the stack nodes. You can get there with this little gear icon or hit shift 9. This is project specific. We're going to go to general options color. And here's where you get access to the node stack layers. By default, it's on one, and you can have up to four, and you can label them here or do a post group node stack. Okay, so what I wanted to show you was how these node stacks flow. So we're on the director node stack, or stack number two, and then we have layer one here. If you wanted to dial in a look and have it intact, you could do that on this first stack, and then if you had a request for some secondary changes without having to mess with your entire node tree or the look that you worked to create, you can choose your second layer. So anything you do on the first L1 is still going to be intact and feed into the clip two layer. And now you can make these changes without altering your first layer. And if you need to disable these, you can just disable them all. And now you're back to your original look, but you don't have to mess up any of the settings within your original node tree. Just keep in mind of the flow from stack one to stack two. It does work like a serial node. One other function, you have this drop-down menu. A new feature is called track node changes using color. So you can give a clip color for whenever something's been altered from your original stack. So let's choose a line here, and I'll go to contrast and keep an eye on this node and the little stripe right here. So if we move, you could see that turned and let us know, hey, there's a change that's been made right here. So that's another option. You can also disable that if you wanted to. Now you do have quite a bit of functionality here in the color dropdown. There's a separate node section. As I said, there's all those shortcuts for adding nodes. There's shortcuts for adding nodes with power windows. There's enable and disable. You can extract a node by hitting the E button. So let's say I didn't want this exposure node in here. I could just hit E. And as you can see, it lifted it out of the line. So you could save a node. Let's say you had one that was cached or bogging down your system. You could add that in later. And then to add that back in, it's kind of like Fusion. You just drag it to the line, it turns yellow, and you let go. And now that's part of the pipeline. So that pretty much shows you guys all the different nodes here, including the shared node and the groups. And that'll get you started on types of nodes and using the nodes. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one.